I'm Zor. Welcome to Unizor Education. And today is the lecture number 8 in a series of different problem-solving lectures related to triangles, quadrangles, parallel lines. These are all elementary problems which we are solving here. There are much more complex and difficult problems, but I will probably put it a little bit later in the course, after we will talk about circles and maybe some other elements. So these are, as I was saying in the previous lecture, your tools, basically. You have to have a toolbox how to solve certain elementary problems. So when more complex ones come along, you will not be actually concentrated on constructing some elementary stuff. You probably will just have it like on automatically, basically. Just as an example, I'm not talking about how to drop a perpendicular from a point to a line. I assume you have already covered it, and this is in your toolbox. And other problems basically are all of the same type. So let me go through this last series of problems. Construct a trapezoid by base, two legs, and one angle formed by that base with one of its legs. So, trapezoid. You have two bases. No, sorry, one base, right? Yeah, one base. Two legs. And one angle formed by that base with. Okay. How can we solve this problem? Well, it's actually relatively easy. When you have a trapezoid, it's kind of common to bring one of the legs close to another one. So from B, we will draw a parallel line E. BE parallel to CD, which means it's also the same, the congruent to CD. So we know it, basically. So we know AB, we know BE, we know this angle. Now, since we know this angle and these two sides in the triangle ABE, we can actually construct it. So we have an angle first, then we measure AB, and then using the radius equal to BE, we just mark where the BE is. Now, I understand that if it's a circle, it can actually intersect in two points, this line, or in one point, or in no points at all. So anyway, let's just assume we have some point E. Now, if we do, so this is what we have meanwhile, right? Now, how to reconstruct the whole trapezoid? Well, you know that AD has a known length, so from A, you just extend beyond point E, and just measure the segment AG. Now from here, you draw a parallel line to this one, and from B, you have parallel line to this one. And here is your trapezoid C. Now, as far as intersection of this circle radius of BE with the line, obviously, if you have two different intersections, then you will have a second solution. Like in this particular case, it will also intersect here as well, because this will be a circle like this, right? So it will intersect here. This line will also be exactly the same size. And basically, again, you can just have the same EG from here, and then you will have not parallel to this, but parallel to this. and it will be C prime. So A, B, C prime, D would be also a trapezoid which has the same base, the same leg, and the same angle. So there are a number of solutions, like in this case, two solutions. If this leg is too short, obviously we will not have any intersection and there is no solution. Or if it's exactly equal to the distance between B and the straight line AD, it will be a perpendicular here. So it will be the right trapezoid, which means one of the angles will be right. It will be both CD and C prime D would be actually close to each other and perpendicular. It will be one line. So it will be one solution. So depending on mutual relationship between the sizes of different components, we will have different number of solutions from 0 to 2. Construct a trapezoid by a difference between bases, diagonal, and two legs. Okay, again, trapezoid, difference between two bases, diagonal, and two legs. Okay, now when you have a difference between two bases, then it's customary, again, as I was saying in the previous problem, bring one of the lines, one of the legs, closer to another. Since these two are congruent to each other, because this is parallelogram, bases are parallel, and this we have constructed as a parallel. The AE exactly is equal to the difference between bases in this case, right? So, besides the difference between the bases, we have diagonal and two legs. So, this leg is congruent to this. Now, this we also have, right? So, we have basically ABE, we have this triangle by three sides, right? Now, the only thing which remains, we do have a diagonal, one of two diagonals. So, how to find points C and G if we have a diagonal? Well, very simple. If you have this, for instance, if you have this diagonal from B to G, so what you do is you take a compass, center at B, the radius is equal to diagonal, and basically mark the arc of this radius and crosses in D. From D you draw a parallel to BE, and equal in size, and you have a Z, you have point C. So that's the end of it. So most importantly is to shift CG to the left, so you will have a triangle ABE, and all three sides of this triangle are equal. Now, whatever happens after this is trivial. You just have the radius or whatever else. This is already simple stuff. Important is to understand that if you have a difference between two bases, then the proper way is just to build this line BE parallel to CE, and that helps you to build piece of this drawing and then expand it any way you want. Construct a trapezoid by its four sides. Okay, so again you have a trapezoid. We have all four sides. Yeah, but look, since we have four sides, that means we can subtract the bases from each other and do exactly the same thing as in the previous problem. Build triangle ABE by side, another side, and the difference between the bases. So it's 2x and difference between the bases. Okay, after that, we don't have a diagonal as in the previous case, but we do have size of AD and size of BC separately, right? So we just extend this line and then using the size of AD basically mark where the point D is supposed to be. You because we have this segment. Now, parallel from point B, parallel to AD, and again, we measure the upper base and the point C. Important thing about this, again, reduce the problem to a simple one, to build this triangle using both legs and difference between the bases. Everything else is not so interesting and very simple. Construct a trapezoid by its base altitude onto it and two diagonals. Okay, trapezoid by base . So we have a base. Now we have an altitude onto it. So basically the distance between these two. So if you have a distance, you draw a perpendicular and draw a parallel line. So that's where the upper base is supposed to be located. But now you have two diagonals, right? One and two. So what you do from A, using the radius of AC, you find the C, and from D, using the radius of BD, you draw B. Again, there are certain variations based on whether we cut in one point or in two points with this circle, etc. So, but these are variations. You can just examine them yourself. But basically, it's enough for this construction. This is the start. This is the beginning. Bottom base and the parallel line, which is distance on the altitude. In every problem, actually, there is something important and something, I would say, technical. There is a creative moment in the very beginning, and then the technicality, which you just, you know, use your regular skills, basically. So in this case, there's not much, basically. You just use altitude as the distance between two parallel lines. That's the most important part. Construct the trapezoid by its two bases and two diagonals. Trapezoid again. Two bases and two diagonals. Well, if you have two bases and two diagonals, I think the best way would be from this point, C, draw a parallel line to a diagonal, to a BD. Now, think about BDEC. It's a parallelogram, right? So these are equal. Now, look at the triangle ACE. In this triangle, we know AC because it's one of the diagonals, CE because it's congruent to another diagonal, and we know this side AE, which is sum of two bases, right? We do have every base. Two bases and two diagonals, right? So we have two bases and two diagonals, which means just combine these two bases together and you have AE. So that's the end of the creative part. This triangle ACE can be built by three sides: diagonal, diagonal, and sum of two bases. Now, from here, how can we basically, how from this particular triangle ACE, how can we reproduce the rest of this? So we started from A, we do AE, we have point C, because this is one diagonal, this is another diagonal, all right? Now, we do have two bases, right? Which means we know separately AG and GE. So that's how from point A we can find point D. We know AD by lines. Okay, so we got this point. What else? Now, obviously from here we have to draw a parallel line because that's where D is supposed to be. Now, from D, we can always use BD as a radius and just put an arc crossing this parallel line using the radius BD and D as the center. And that's how you get the B. That's it. Well, I'd like you to notice that basically when we are dealing with trapezoids, most of the problems were related to some kind of a shift. Either we shift a side closer to a side or diagonal outside of the trapezoid. It's kind of a typical with trapezoids, so most of the problems related to trapezoids can be solved using one or another methods by shifting left or right, diagonals or sides. That's the purpose of solving many problems of relatively close conditions, because it kind of develops the skill, okay, these are typical methods to solve these problems, all right? Okay, construct parallelogram by two diagonals and an altitude. Okay, parallelogram, two diagonals, and an altitude. Well, there are, again, many ways of solving this particular problem. As an example, let's think about this one. A, B, C, D, E. Now, obviously, ACE is a right triangle. And we know hypotenuse and a catetus. So we can build it. Now, knowing this, okay, we know this. What else is known to us? Two diagonals and an altitude. Okay, so we have used one diagonal, but we have another one. So we can draw a parallel line here. That's where the BC would be, right? Now, this diagonal is intersecting with another diagonal in the midpoint. So, we basically know what BP is equal. BP is half of this diagonal. So, using BP as a radius, now, the center of AC, the midpoint, is P, obviously. You can just have an arc here, which basically gives you the point P. So, since you know this. Well, obviously my drawing is not exactly correct. It's supposed to be somehow B. That would be B, and this would be A, and this would be C. That would be the parallelogram. So, important thing is, ACE is a triangle which we can build, because it's a right triangle, we know hypotenuse and the catetus. And what's important thing, how to find the point B, having BD as a diagonal, we know the BP, which is half of it, and using the half of it, we just find this point. Now, I wonder what happens if you find another point here. Would that be the same thing? Then diagonal would be this one. And it would be this type of a parallelogram, I guess. Something like this. Well, it has exactly the same two diagonals, this one, and exactly the same height. So in this case, there are two solutions. So a number of solutions can be more than one, as you see. It's only in the triangle when you have three sides, you have only one solution. And not always, by the way, because there is a triangle inequality, like if sides are A, B, and C, then A plus B should be greater than C. So there are certain conditions. There are certain triangles you cannot build. But in this case, not only there are cases when you cannot build something, there are cases when you can build more than one something. In this case, parallelogram. Okay. Construct a parallelogram by side, sum of two diagonals, and angle between them.
Parallelogram.
Side, sum of two.
Okay. Let's have two diagonals. So you have a side, you have sum of two diagonals and angle between them.
Right, but let's think about this way. Let me reduce the problem to a simpler one. You have a side, you have an angle, you have sum of two diagonals, but diagonals are crossing in the midpoint, which means sum of two diagonals is twice as big as AP plus BD. So let's consider triangle APD. Triangle which has one side known, sum of two sides, also known, and an angle between these two sides. So let's just completely change the problem and let's just solve this one. How to construct a triangle by side and sum of two other sides and angle between them. Okay, to do that is usually if you have sum of two sides, you have to extend one side by the lengths equal to this one. Now, what do we know about, let me just use similar letters, or rather, this is C, and this is D. Now, what do we know about ADD, ADC, sorry, ADC? Well, we know AD, we know AC, because this is the given. And actually, we know that this triangle BCD is isosceles by construction. We know this angle, which is exterior angle, which means these are halves of this angle. So knowing this angle, we know half of these angle, so we know this one. That's important. So ADC, we have an angle, we have a side, and we have another side. Now we can build a triangle using two sides, an angle opposite to one of these sides, using whatever methodology we used before. We did solve this problem many times before. So now we know how to build this triangle ADC. Now, after building ADC, we draw a perpendicular bisector to CD to get the point B. I already have a point B. And now we have built ABC. So, my point was that knowing AP plus PD, angle between them, and AD, we can build a PD triangle. And let's just use it. Since we can build APD, everything else is trivial. Just extend AP by the same lengths and extend PD by the same lengths, and that's how you get to other points of the parallelogram. Okay. Construct a triangle by side altitude on it and median to another side.
side, altitude, onto this side, and the median to another side. So this is altitude. BG is perpendicular to AC, and AE is median. So these two pieces are congruent to each other. So we need base, height, or altitude, and median to a side. All right, so what can we do about it? Okay, here is something which we can consider. Let's just draw a perpendicular from here with the F. Oops, sorry. So we have this. Now this is half of the altitude, obviously, because these are equal pieces, and that's why if you draw this line, it will divide BD in half. So EF is half of BD. If BD is known, EF is known as well. So what should we do is, we can draw AC. Let's consider AEC. What do we know about AEC? We know side, which is median in the big triangle, another side, AC, and we know its height. So using AC, we start with this. Using this altitude, you draw a parallel line, and using AE, a median known to you, this is a center, you just find the point E, just using the compass. Now, since you have these three points, everything else is easy. Again, the constructive part is finished. So you connect C to E, you extend it to the same lengths to get the B, and that's it. That's your triangle. So what was important here? To basically understand that AEC is a triangle where you also have three elements. You remember that for triangles you need three elements. You have the same base AC as a big triangle. Now AE, the median, becomes a side of it, but the third element, and that's what you have to really, you know, kind of think about why it's important. The height of this, the altitude, is equal to half of the given altitude. Only because E is a midpoint. And that's why every line parallel to it cuts in half every other line connecting B to any point on the base. Which we also, by the way, proved before. All right. There was a little bit to kind of guess here about this altitude, that it's equal to half, but sorry. Okay, construct right triangle by hypotenuse and sum of two catheti. I think we did something similar as a auxiliary problem for a previous problem, but let's do it again. So you have a right triangle. You have hypotenuse and sum of two catheties. All right, so as usual, we extend one side and just have this one turned by 90 degree to this one. So now, if this is ABC, our initial triangle, what do we know about AD? B. Well, we know a lot, actually. We know, well, this side, we know
this side, now this is original hypotenuse. Now this side is sum of two catheti, so we know it as well. And we know an angle. Angle is 45 degrees, which we know what it is. So by side and another side and an angle opposite to one of these two sides, again, we solved this problem before. We can build a triangle ABG, and having ABG, we just have BG and perpendicular bisector gives us the point C. Construct a right triangle by hypotenuse and the difference between two catheti. Okay, it was the sum, now it's difference. It's very similar, actually. So now, instead of turning this particular catheter down to extend another catheter, we have to turn it up. Why? To have the difference between two catheters. Now, what can we say about this situation? So, if this is original triangle ABC, what can we say about ADB? What's known? Hypotenuse, difference between two catheti, which is AD, and we need the third element, right? So we have hypotenuse and difference between two catheti, right? So the third element is probably some kind of an angle. Now we don't have an angle, we have 45 degrees here, which is sum of these two angles. Now, does it help us? Let me think about it. What can we do about it? So in this case, we had this angle is 45 degrees. In this, oh yes, absolutely. This angle is 135 degrees. It's supplemental to 45, right? So again, same situation. We have triangle ADB with one known side, another known side, and an angle opposite to one of these two sides. Same thing, we can always build it. And from this triangle, ADB, we can find the point C by exactly the same technique. Perpendicular bisector to BD will give us the C, since this is the equilateral triangle, BGC. All right. And I think the very last problem. Given a straight line and two points A and B on one side of the line, given also a segment MN, segment MN. We have to find two points X and Y on the line such that segment XY is congruent to MN, so they have the same lengths, and sum of these three segments, AX plus XY plus YB is minimal. Okay. Let me just remind you another problem. If you have line and two points, A and B, and you have to find a point P, let's say, such that this AP plus PB is minimal, What do you do in this case? You reflect B relative to this line, so you draw a perpendicular and extend it by the same length. Then you connect, this is B prime, then you connect A and B prime with a straight line, and A, B prime actually crosses the line at point P, and APB would be minimal. Why? Because if you will take any other point, let's say this one, P prime, and you connect AP. Now, if you reflect again the P prime B to P prime B prime, the lengths will be equal. So sum of these two will be exactly like sum of these two. But this is not a straight line. AB prime is a straight line. A straight line is shorter than anything else between two points. So by reflecting B relative to this line to B prime and connecting to I, you will get the point P to minimize AP plus PB. Any other point would be greater, because AP prime plus P prime B prime is definitely greater than AB prime, direct line. Okay, so with a point, we know how to solve this problem. Now, what if there is a segment here instead of a point? Well, we will just reduce this problem to this. How? Well, simply. Let's just draw a parallel line. Now let's think. AX plus XY plus YB, if this is, forget about B prime, let's use C. You see, XY is a constant, so no matter where point B is, if you will shift it by this particular segment to the left, so regardless of where this particular, maybe it will be in this position, let's say, this position, X prime, Y prime, and it will be this way. After you shift it, you still have that the sum of these two is different from the total sum by a constant. So basically what I'm saying is, if you shift B to the left by this length parallel to the line to point C, and then you solve this problem between A and C, then it actually solves the problem where you have this particular segment inserted in between, because all you have to do is just add a constant to already minimal way from A to X to C. So A to X to C plus constant, which is this length, is always A from A to X, from X to Y, and from Y to B, no matter where X, Y is positioned. So we find the point X as the point, like in this particular case, with the minimum sum of distances AX plus XC. So after you shift it to the left, point B to a position C, then you just have to have C prime symmetrical to C relative to this line, so they are on the same perpendicular on the same distance. Draw a straight line from A to C prime, and this is where your X is supposed to be. Then measure this distance from X, and that would be your Y. So this to B would be your minimum way, minimum distance. All right? So again, you shift B to the left, and basically you reduce by this segment, which basically reduced the problem to minimize the distance with this constant piece in between to the previous problem where you just have to find one point. Okay, that's it. That actually completes my set of simple problems related to straight lines, parallelograms, trapezoid, rhombuses, triangles, etc. Everything which precedes the circles, let's put it this way. Now, again, these are simple problems. These are your toolbox. You have to use them for more complex problems. And little creative things which we did in every problem are very useful. So you have to really like think about, okay, if it's a trapezoid, maybe you have to shift either your side or your diagonal to the right or to the left. Whatever the additional construction is required, the more elementary problems you solve, like these simple ones, where you usually need just one simple extra line or something like this to basically reduce the problem to something which you have already done before, that's important. So the more problems you solve like these, the better you're off. And that's exactly where your creativity actually is being developed, as you just think about, okay, how can I reduce this problem to that problem which I already know? So that's the kind of a philosophical spiel which I'm making about creativity and about mathematics, which, in my personal opinion, develops this type of creativity, which can be used anywhere. My next set of theoretical lectures will be about circles, and then will be another problems, and then I'm planning to have some more difficult problems. Now, meanwhile, Unizor is your focal point for, I would say, advanced and deeper kind of knowledge about school-level mathematics, advanced-level, school-level mathematics, whatever. And what's important is you can obviously just listen to lectures, solve the problems, etc., without any kind of control or process, if you wish. But I do encourage parents who are interested in more controlled environment and studying deeper the mathematics with their children. They have the ability to do it with Unizor by enrolling their children to this or that program, to a specific topic or a bunch of topics, and watch how they pass exams, check the scores, and basically control, you know, pass or fail, asking your child to repeat the same course again and to go through the same exam again to get better score. All right, that's it. Thank you very much and good luck.